Hi, in my previous video, we discussed about what is drug, what is dosage forms, and how the dosage forms are classified. In this classification of dosage form, one classification was based on the routes of drug administration. In today's video, we will discuss in detail about the various routes of drug administration and its importance. This video module will help you define the routes of drug administration, classify different routes of drug administration, differentiate between local route and the systemic route, explain advantages and disadvantages of oral route, explain advantages and disadvantages of parenteral route, and explain different type of parenteral routes. The route of drug administration is defined as the path by which a drug is taken into the body for diagnosis, prevention, cure, or treatment of disease and disorders. In previous video, I explained you. मैंने आपको बताया था कि drug क्या होता है? Drug is a substance जो कि किसी भी रोग के, किसी भी बीमारी के diagnosis के लिए, उसके बीमारी के रोकथाम के लिए, बीमारी के क्योर करने के लिए, बीमारी के लक्षण के इलाज करने के लिए इस्तेमाल किया जाता है. और रूट्स ऑफ ड्रग एडमिनिस्ट्रेशन क्या है कि उस ड्रग को शरीर के उस भाग तक लेके जाना जहां पे बीमारी है. वो डिफरेंट जो रूट्स हैं जिसके द्वारा उसको वहां तक लेके जाया जाता है उसको रूट्स ऑफ ड्रग एडमिनिस्ट्रेशन बोलते हैं. द रूट्स ऑफ ड्रग एडमिनिस्ट्रेशन ऑफ अ मेडिकेशन directly affect the drug bioavailability, which determines both the onset and the duration of pharmacological effect. इसका मतलब ये हुआ कि जो route of drug administration है वो किसी भी दवा के bioavailability, मतलब वो शरीर के अंदर काम करने के लिए कितना जल्दी उपलब्ध होगा उसको determine करता है. दोनों तरह से onset, मतलब कितना fast वो काम करना शुरू करेगा, दैट इज द ऑनसेट ऑफ एक्शन, एंड कितनी देर तक काम करता रहेगा, दैट इज द ड्यूरेशन ऑफ फार्माकोलॉजिकल इफेक्ट. तो अब ये देखते हैं कि रूट्स ऑफ ड्रग एडमिनिस्ट्रेशन को क्लासिफाई कैसे किया गया. तो एक्चुअल क्लासिफिकेशन में जाने से पहले हमको ये समझना है कि ड्रग का कितने तरीके से इस्तेमाल होता है, कितने तरीके से शरीर के अंदर में ड्रग को प्रयोग किया जाता है. तो पहला तरीका यह है जिसको बोलते हैं सिस्टेमिक एप्लीकेशन. सिस्टेमिक एप्लीकेशन में क्या है कि ड्रग जो है सिस्टेमिक सर्कुलेशन के अंदर एंटर करता है और सिस्टेमिक सर्कुलेशन के थ्रू वो हमारे साइट ऑफ एक्शन तक जाता है. मींस द ड्रग इज एंटरिंग इनटू द सिस्टेमिक सर्कुलेशन एंड फ्रॉम थ्रू द सिस्टेमिक सर्कुलेशन इट इज गोइंग टिल द साइट ऑफ एक्शन. The second type of application is that is called local application. Local application का मतलब क्या हो गया कि drug को directly जहां पे actual में problem है वहां पे ही direct लगा पहुंचा देना, वो that is called local application. अभी मैं आपको systemic application और local application का अंतर समझाता हूँ. जैसे systemic application में अगर आपके सर में दर्द है और अगर आपने paracetamol tablet लिया तो क्या होगा कि पहले आप उसको oral route से लेंगे, लेने के बाद वो एब्जॉर्ब होगा, एब्जॉर्ब होकर के वो आपके ब्लड सर्कुलेशन में जाएगा, ब्लड सर्कुलेशन के थ्रू इट विल रीच टू योर साइट ऑफ एक्शन जहां पर सर में आपको दर्द हो रहा है. या फिर अगर मान लीजिए कि आपके पैर में चोट लगी है और वहां पे आपको दर्द हो रहा है, आपने आइबुप्रोफेन या डाइक्लोफेनाक इस तरह का कोई ड्रग लिया तो वो भी आपके पहले सिस्टेमिक सर्कुलेशन में जाएगा. सिस्टेमिक सर्कुलेशन में जाने के बाद वो वहां से वो आपके ब्लड सर्कुलेशन के थ्रू उस जगह पे पहुंचेगा जहां पर आपको दर्द हो रहा है और वहां पे जाकर के वो अपना काम करके आपके दर्द को रिलीव करेगा. तो दिस इज कॉल्ड सिस्टेमिक एप्लीकेशन. सिस्टेमिक एप्लीकेशन के लिए एक सबसे इंपॉर्टेंट चीज क्या है कि अगर जहां पे आपको दर्द है वहां पे जितना ड्रग चाहिए उस दर्द को रिलीव करने के लिए वो ड्रग का कॉन्सेंट्रेशन पूरे शरीर में आपको मेंटेन करना पड़ेगा. देन ओनली यू विल गेट रिलीफ. सपोज इफ यू आर हैविंग सम पेन, यू आर हैविंग पेन हियर, आपके इस अंगूठे में चोट लगा है और यहाँ पे आपको दर्द है और यहाँ पे आपको जो ड्रग का कॉन्सेंट्रेशन चाहिए वो केवल 1 माइक्रोग्राम पर लीटर का कॉन्सेंट्रेशन चाहिए, 1 माइक्रोग्राम पर लीटर। लेकिन अगर आप सिस्टमिक रूट से ले रहे हैं तो क्या है कि आपके पूरे शरीर में, पूरे बॉडी में, जितना भी पूरा ब्लड है, बॉडी फ्लूइड है, उसके अंदर 1 माइक्रोग्राम पर लीटर का कॉन्सेंट्रेशन मेंटेन करना पड़ेगा। देन ओनली यू विल गेट रिलीफ इन दिस पर्टिकुलर एरिया। लोकल एप्लीकेशन में क्या है कि आपको यहाँ पे चोट लगा, आप यहाँ पे आपने ऑइंटमेंट लगा दिया, वोलिनी जेल यहाँ पे लगा दिया, नाइस जेल आपने लगा दिया, और यहाँ से सीधा वो इस एरिया में ड्रग आपका इफेक्ट करके वो केवल इसी एरिया में ड्रग लगेगा और यहाँ से ही आपको रिलीफ कर देगा। उस केस में पूरे बॉडी में आपको कॉन्सेंट्रेशन मेंटेन करने की जरूरत नहीं है। सो दिस इज द डिफरेंस बिटवीन द सिस्टमिक एप्लीकेशन एंड लोकल एप्लीकेशन। नाउ लेट अस मूव टू डिफरेंट क्लासिफिकेशन ऑफ रूट्स ऑफ ड्रग एडमिनिस्ट्रेशन। द रूट्स ऑफ ड्रग एडमिनिस्ट्रेशन इज मेनली क्लासिफाइड इनटू 3 कैटेगरी। सो द फर्स्ट इज द इंटरल रूट। इंटरल रूट मीन्स when your drug is touching any part of your gastrointestinal tract. So this particular route is called enteral route. The other part, it is called parenteral route. Parenteral route means it is not touching your gastrointestinal tract. And the third classification, third category, that is the topical route. So basically topical route is also, it's a parenteral route only, but there is a slightly different. So let us see the classification of enteral route. In enteral route, the first category is the sublingual route. So what is the sublingual route? Sublingual route is the route where the tablet or the drug, it is placed below the tongue here. This area is very rich in blood circulation, blood capillary is very rich in blood capillary network. So if something is placed here, it directly getting very fast absorbed, very fast dissolved, because there's a lot of saliva and all those things is there, and then it is getting absorbed. And from here, यहाँ से absorb होने के बाद वो सीधा blood circulation में जाता है। इसका एक सबसे बड़ा benefit ये है, the advantage of this particular route is that drug is directly going into the main blood circulation, the systemic circulation from this particular place. It is bypassing the first pass metabolism also. So there is, drug is not going in liver. Whereas when something is taken as a oral, when it is getting absorbed in the intestine, in that particular case, drug is passing through the liver. Liver se pass hota hai aur wahan pe first pass metabolism mein, there are many drugs that is getting metabolized. But in case of sublingual, it is that particular first pass metabolism or the liver part, it is getting bypassed. So this is one of the, from the oral route, this is the fastest route of drug administration or drug absorption. So this is the benefit. But the disadvantage of this particular route is that the place is very small. You cannot put large size tablet. The tablet should be very small. The second route of administration from the oral is the buccal. Buccal means you are putting the tablet somewhere here, like that, like lozenges you are putting. So when, again, this is from here, you can put slightly larger size of tablet. The rate of absorption is slightly slower than the sublingual. But here again, you cannot put, even in the sublingual route also, if the taste of your drug is not good, then people will not take that particular. If the tablet is or the medicine is tasteless or it is having some good taste, that will work. Otherwise, it will not work with either sublingual or with buccal route. The third is the oral route. Oral route means ingesting. So in this particular case, what happened? Tablet is ingested with the help of water. The tablet is taken through the water. It crosses the esophagus and goes into the stomach. The tablet is getting disintegrated into the stomach. From stomach, it is getting absorbed. The disadvantage of this particular route is many drugs not sustaining the acidic environment, or many non-steroidal anti-inflammatory drugs like aspirin, diclofenac. These drugs are causing gastric irritation because the drug is acidic in nature. It goes inside and then it gets precipitated. It is causing irritation. There are certain drugs like omeprazole. That drug is getting destroyed. So you will not get the benefit of that. So for that particular purpose, there are certain coating required. After doing the coating, that drug, that dosage form, the tablet or capsule, it will sustain that acidic environment, because in acidic environment, it will not disintegrate and it will not release. वो आपका पेट में जा करके जो स्टमक है जहां पे एसिड है वहां पे डिसइंटीग्रेट नहीं होगा, वहां पे ड्रग रिलीज नहीं होगा. लेकिन उसमें क्या होता है कि वो आपका ड्रग का रिलीज डिले हो जाएगा. अभी मान लीजिए कि आपको चोट लगा है पैर एंड यू वांट टू टेक अ डाइक्लोफेनेक टैबलेट. डाइक्लोफेनेक टैबलेट इज एंटेरिक कोटेड टैबलेट. अगर आपने वो टैबलेट लिया तो जब तक वो आपके स्टमक, करीब 1.5 से 2 घंटे तक, जब तक वो टैबलेट आपके स्टमक से निकल करके इंटेस्टाइन तक नहीं पहुंच जाता है, तब तक वो टैबलेट डिसइंटीग्रेट नहीं होगा. और अगर वो टैबलेट डिसइंटीग्रेट नहीं होगा तो आपको उस टैबलेट का असर नहीं होगा, आपको दर्द से रिलीफ नहीं मिलेगा. मतलब कि टैबलेट खाने के बाद भी 2 घंटे तक आप दर्द से परेशान रहेंगे. सो दिस इज द डिसएडवांटेज ऑफ ओरल रूट. But oral route is one of the most convenient and the most widely used route of drug administration. Majority of drug, it is being taken. Second major disadvantage of this particular route is if somebody is unconscious, you cannot use this particular route for administering the drug for an unconscious person. Now, the fourth enteral route is the rectal route. In this particular route, the drug dosage form is inserted into the rectum in the form of suppositories or rectal tablets or in the form of enema. Again, the absorption is slow, but from here also the first pass metabolism is bypassed, and this particular route can be used for unconscious patients. The disadvantage is many conscious patients don't like this route. So this is about the enteral route. Now we are coming to the parenteral route. The parenteral route, basically it is injections. In injections, we are having different kinds of injection, like subcutaneous injection. Subcutaneous injection means it is skin. Skin ka upar ka jo layer hai, usme ja karke injection dena. So while putting the injection, the needle should be put at around 10 degree angle and it is inserted. So this is the subcutaneous. Then it comes to intramuscular. Intramuscular, the injection is given deep inside the muscle. Then it comes to intravenous. In case of intravenous, the injection is given inside the veins. Then intraosseous. Intraosseous means injection or the fluid is injected in the bone marrow. Then intracardiac, drug is directly injected inside the heart. There are injections where inserted in the artery, the drug is injected inside the artery. So depending on the various application, like subcutaneous, it will take some time to start the acting. Intramuscular, again it's slow. If you want quick response, intravenous. Once it is put in intravenous, immediately it will systemic circulation. And within few seconds, you will start getting the effect of that particular drug. But the disadvantage is that once it is injected, you cannot withdraw. If by some problem happens, some wrong medication is given, then you cannot withdraw. In case of oral, you can initiate the vomiting. There is a way to withdraw that particular thing. But in case of intravenous, it cannot be withdrawn. Even in case of intramuscular also, it cannot be withdrawn. Again, intrathecal injections, intraosseous injections. These injections are require some expert to administer. Everybody cannot. Even intravenous injection also, trained nurse or trained healthcare worker required. For administering injections, trained people required. Intracardiac injection, intraosseous injection, intrathecal injection, where injection is given in the spinal cord. So for that, very trained persons are required. Now, the other next classification, it is the topical route. So in topical route, the first important route is the inhalation route. You can put either by inhalation or nasal spray, nasal route, nasal spray or nasal drop. So this is a route. And again, if it is taken by the inhalation, if it is taken by the inhalation, the drug directly goes inside the lungs. And from alveoli, it is getting absorbed very fast. This is the second fastest route than the intravenous route, because drug is going inside the lungs and immediately it is going in the systemic circulation. Topical route is the ocular route. Ocular route means when something is applied inside the eyes, eye drops, eye ointment. These are the ocular route. Then otic route. Otic means drug is put inside the ear, eardrops. Then there is one route, vaginal route. Drugs for the local vaginal infection or some problem. It is vaginal tablets or suppositories. It is inserted inside the vagina. And the drug is getting dissolved in the vaginal fluid and it is distributed, getting absorbed. The next is the dermal route. Dermal means applying the ointment. And that particular ointment, it is, suppose you are having the burn, then you will apply burn on. If you are having some itch, rash or something like that, you will apply itch guard. So these are the dermal route. Now, there are routes. We cannot say that, okay, oral route is only for systemic. No, it is not like that. See, there are drugs, like when you are taking antacid, like diazin, chewable tablet of diazin. It goes inside and it acts locally in your stomach. There is no systemic absorption of that particular drug. In the similar way, there are antibiotics. There is one antibiotic I will tell, that is the colistin sulfate. Colistin sulfate is a microbial antibiotic and it is used to treat gastrointestinal infection for infants. Kids, those are very small, like 6 months, 2 months, 3 months. If they are having some infection, so that colistin sulfate solution, it is a dry powder solution, it is given. And that drug, that antibiotic, it's antibiotic, but it is working locally inside the gastrointestinal tract. There is no systemic absorption of that drug. In the similar way, when albendazole tablets are taken, albendazole tablet, 90% it works as a local to kill the infection inside the intestine. So these are taken by oral route, but these drugs are working locally. There are certain drugs, certain application like transdermal patches. It is applied on skin, but it is being used for systemic application of drug. So here what happened, that patches are applied and those patches are slowly it is releasing the drug over a long period of time, and it is for systemic use. So here, based on the application of drug, so whether that particular route for systemic application or for the local application. So this is regarding, so this is about routes of drug administration. If you are having any question, you can ask me by writing in the comment. If you like this particular video, please share with your friends. I'm sure that you will learn a lot of things. You must be having a lot of doubts also. So whatever you doubts, you just connect back. Ask me through the comments. I will ensure that it is clarified. So with this, I will conclude my today's session. I'm sure that you must have enjoyed and learned a lot. I'm 100% sure you must be having a lot of doubt, lot of comments. So please share your doubt, your questions in the comment. I will come back and clarify your doubts. Thank you very much and happy learning.